to teach the lab related topics and everything, because it has been found that it is very difficult to especially do lab activities with students in schools, because in this pandemic mode, everything has gone online, and you can still have some conversations on in online mode, but doing lab activities has been really, really challenging. So we do hope that today Sai Bhavya will show us a few resources, and perhaps we will be able to engage students in doing lab related activities and to make them more curious about science and generate some interest in science itself. Yeah, so over to you, Sai Bhavya. Can
Yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. This is Sai Bhavya Prabhu. I'll be explaining you about certain online resources which will make your life better, because in this new normal, we all are struggling with our lesson plans and with various resources in order to make our lessons more interactive. So we'll be using, I'll be basically focusing on a resource on a website called as Lab Exchange. It was started in January this year, and this website belongs to Harvard Education, when most of, you know, highly qualified teachers have put their efforts in order so that every person can use this resource, you know, for this online learning. So let's start. I'll be sharing my presentation. Is my presentation visible, Ruchi?
Yes, it is visible. Can you go in presentation mode?
Yeah, I'm going. Once. Okay, so today's title for our webinar is Integrating Personalized Learning in Science Pedagogy. How we are going to deal with our science learning and how we are making it personalized, like every student of your class is able to focus. It's not only the ones out of 20, only two are not like that. Everyone is getting a personalized activity so that they can focus and concentrate. So what are the session learning outcomes? The participants in this session are able to apply Lab Exchange framework for their lab and field-based activities. They'll identify several alternative models for teaching labs. And the third session learning outcome is to identify potential interactive tools. Like, we'll be using some interactive tools in our sessions where you can actually utilize in your classroom environment. What is today's webinar agenda? What is Lab Exchange? So it has some assets, pathways, and all that. I'll be focusing on that. The second part is evidence-based learning, and the third is question and answers. So I want you all to just mark on the screen, annotate on the screen, in which part of the world or in which part of the state, if you're in India, so in which part of the state can you all, can you just start marking? Because I see all of y'all, your videos are off and everything. I want the session to be more interactive there. So just like, you become dull, right? When your students don't keep your videos on and, you know, they don't listen to you. So I just want the same with y'all also. I want y'all to keep your videos on, start annotating on the screen. Yes, you can use the annotate tool, which is present on your screen, and start annotating like which part of the world are you. If you are there in Karnataka, just annotate in the part of Karnataka there. If you are there in Mumbai, just part annotate in the part of Mumbai. Or just give a tick, a star, something there. I want you all to do it.
Are you able to annotate? Somebody has done. Yeah.
No, ma'am.
No, we aren't able to annotate.
You have to go to annotate, click on it, and then a pencil comes up.
No, that is not visible actually.
If you are on your mobile, you have to double click on the screen.
No, we are on desktop. I mean, on laptop, sorry.
Yeah.
But here in view option, above the screen where usually it appears,
okay,
annotation, it is not available. It's not seen.
Let me check the back end in a
moment. On double tapping, ma'am, it's getting zoom in. So,
okay. Just let me check. Annotations, just let me check.
Are you able to annotate, Ruchi?
Actually, even for me, it's not coming. So, I'll have to.
Let me check the back end, Ruchi. I'll just.
Yeah, we'll get back to this slide later. Still then,
maybe at the end we can do that.
Yeah. So now before joining, I want you all to go to the breakout rooms. So before joining the breakout rooms, I just want you all to name yourself, okay? I don't want your proper name and surname then. I want your name, your weakness, one strength, and a pronoun. Just next to your self, just rename it. Are you able to rename yourself, everyone? Guys, are you able to rename yourself?
Yes. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. We can rename.
Yeah. So, no. You have to go to the three columns next to your picture. You can see your picture, right? Next to mute, you can see three dots. Go to the dot and there will be rename. Just type rename. Right now, you can see mine. I have just Ruchi. I want you also to try Deepa.
Can you guide me? I don't know much about this.
So, can you go to the screen? Your picture is there, right? Where your picture is there?
Yes. Got it.
On that, you can see mute and three dots, right? So yes. On the three dots, you have to, Ruchi and Deepa, I want you all also to do this.
Okay, got it, ma'am. Thank you.
Please check once again, somebody. I've, just redone the settings.
Yeah. We'll do it later to complete this activity. Ruchi, are you able to do it? Rename yourself?
Yeah, I am renaming. It's possible. Yeah.
So I want you all to do it fast. So you can see mine. I have just renamed myself from Sai Bhavya Prabhu to this. I want you all to do. So these are certain things when we start our class with our students, no? In order to make them enthusiastic, some active, no? We can give these starting sessions. Before our lesson begins. Yeah, very good. I can see people writing creative, I want everyone to take part.
What exactly, ma'am, you're asking to write?
So,
ma'am,
yourself.
You have to write an adjective, a pronoun, and a weakness. Just like you can see an example here, my name. An adjective, a pronoun, and a weakness.
Ma'am, I removed my name, so the name should stay. I thought we have to skip the name.
it's okay, ma'am. It's fine. Okay. You. It's okay. Okay. So once we are done, we are going to go into the breakout rooms. Okay. It will be for 5 minutes where you'll introduce yourself to each other and which class you teach. And what is your biggest challenge you are facing right now? In terms of virtual labs and during the online labs, what is the biggest challenge you're facing? So we'll discuss on this. And each group should have a reporter. Okay, each group, if you are 5 people, you should have one reporter who will be noting all the points so that when you come back from the breakout room, you'll discuss what were the points discussed. Clear? Yes. So it is up to you who will be the reporter in the breakout room. I think the session is very silent. I want interaction to take place. Yes, guys. Please.
Okay, ma'am. Got it.
Yeah, thanks. Okay, Deepak, you can send them to breakout rooms now.
So, I'm making 4 rooms, so 5 to 6 participants per room, right?
Yeah. And one person should be the reporter, okay, who will be reporting everything.
So, as soon as you get into the room, you have to assign someone as a reporter. And discuss this question and then come back and report what you had.
We'll paste these questions in the breakout room. We'll send these questions.
Okay, yeah. Ma'am.
I think more people have joined.
Yes, right, people now are joining.
Yeah.
Ma'am, can I ask you something?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, in the Q&A, I'll ask you, ma'am. It's not important, but I'll ask you in the Q&A.
So I have opened the rooms, so you can join. Tabassum, you have to join breakout room one. Deepa, Farheen Samnani, you have to join breakout room three. Please click on that breakout room option that has come.
Aruchi, you want me to join a breakout room? Because people are still coming in. I'll probably have to wait.
Yeah, here. So Krishna Veni is asking for help in breakout room two. People are also joining right now.
Yeah. That's why I thought I wouldn't join. I'll be here.
I'll just go and come back and quickly.
Huh? Yeah. I'll just wait here.
Sai Bhavya, if you can just... Is she here?
I think she has entered her breakout room. So she'll be back. Maybe number one. People are still joining. There are four people by the name of Rita Makija. I don't know if it's one person with many accounts.
So those who are here, you have to click on the link that has appeared for joining the breakout room on your screen. Please join. Hi, Bhavya. You're mute. Bhavya, you're mute.
Yeah, Ruchi. Can you hear me?
Yes, now I can hear you.
These are the new participants.
Yeah, they are joining even now. So I have assigned them. They are still to click on the...
But is it done? We have the session for 3 minutes or 5 minutes is done. So we have to get them back.
So should I close rooms?
If it is 5 minutes are done, just keep an eye on the time there. If it is
done, so just 1 more minute is left.
Okay, just we'll send a message. Send a message to the participants. Breaker room will close in a minute.
Okay. People are joining now, actually.
Even now, there's quite a few.
Yeah, so that is the issue.
You can ask them to go to the next breakout session later.
Okay.
So we can have we can have it. I just want to know, like, what are your difficulties you are facing in online teaching? You can get just type in the chat. The participants who are there in the main session, just type in the chat, like, what are the difficulties you're facing?
Yeah, that would be good.
Is everyone back?
Yeah, just they'll be back in 30 seconds. Huge issue about network and data usage. That is one problem.
That is the problem which, you know, we can't solve. Like, how much we try to dig, we can't solve that problem.
Any other person would like to share what kind of problems? What kind of challenges you face, and especially in doing lab activities?
Okay, for the labs, I can help you. I can show some interactive sessions which we are using.
We don't know what students are actually doing. One of the person is saying, Anjali Makwana is saying, we don't know what students are actually doing.
I can see
good to have your videos on, and we can see some faces.
I'm happy now the session is becoming a little bit interactive there. So the people who joined now, I want you all to rename yourself. Write down an adjective for your name instead of me seeing there Miss Nutan Iyer and Bula Rani. I want you to write some adjective to your name. Rename yourself. Yeah. Like, you think this adjective fits me and this is my weakness. So just write it down. I'm very creative. I'm very practical. I'm, you know. Okay, I think everyone is back, right?
Yes, people are back. You can continue. Yeah.
So let us go to the next part of the PPT there. It's visible, Ruchi?
Yes, it's visible. You can start.
So we have done with the breakout room sessions. I understood, like, which class you all are teaching and what is the biggest challenge you're facing. So we'll get back to this in the next when we'll find some solution to it. So now I'm going to speak about lab exchange. What is the purpose? Like, what is the purpose of us as being a teachers? Like, to teach and inspire the users, especially our users are the students, think of themselves as scientists, you know, develop that science feeling in them. Because nowadays, if you see a survey and all that, everyone wants to be an economist or a business related goal or something. Science is something, once upon a time, it is considered as a big, you know, discipline where, you know, so many opportunities are there. But right now, the people who want to be a scientist or who want to enter science fields are very less. So being a science teachers, we face these problems, right? We face these problems. We try to face this problem, especially with physics, when the teachers want to teach some, you know, some concepts which are imaginary to the students. So for all these purposes, we are going to use one thing called as lab exchange. It was actually created in January 22nd, 2020. And it is still September 17th, you know, 240 days since it was done. There was a survey done. So this was created by Harvard University there, by the professors who are working, especially for the teachers who are doing this online learning and all that. And if you see the top 5 countries which you use this lab exchange, 33% of the Indians use this lab exchange. So I'm just going to show you how this works. So I just want you all to give me a second. I'll just go to that. Okay.
So any other?
So you don't require anything there. You don't need to create an account or something for this. You can just randomly type labexchange.org in the Google. It will go to this site. So you have to just click on the library there. Once you open the library, you have to search. You have to give the key here. Like if you want to do for gel electrophoresis. So just type gel electrophoresis simulation. It will take you to this. Now let's see how it works. You can see here. So just start the simulation. So it will give you various levels. This is for the level, if the student is like 8th and 9th standard, so you can go for level 1. If the student is 10th or 12th standard, they then go for level 2. If the student is postgraduate, he's doing his bachelor's or master's, then go for level 3. So depending upon what is the requirement, you select that, then start the simulation. Then once you get, there will be a small, you can see these contents to the right side of the screen there. Context, materials, predictions, protocol, results, reflection, and summary. So why do you need to do before this laboratory starts? What are the requirements? What are the materials you need to gather? So that you have to do it. Then go to predictions, which I want to do with my students. Because before we do the lab, just ask them. Now the DNA is negatively charged. So definitely when you do an electrophoretic gel, it has to go to positive side. So just these kind of predictions they have to make. The students can make, okay? So is this the positive electrode or the negative electrode that they are setting and all that? Then go for the materials. So what are the materials required? You can explain them, like the pipette, which pipette you want, what is the ml of the pipette used, or what is the tip size, everything you can select depending. Then it has a protocol. So protocol is this what? So once you start the simulation, so this is the lab environment. Okay, you just start using it. You just have to drag it, whatever you want. You want this thing, just do it. If you want to take this pipette, just drag it, drop it in this. Before doing that, you need to go to a micro pipette in order to get the tip, right? And you want to dispose this, just click. And if you want to press this, it will remove the pipette too. So everything is guided in the lab. You have to just follow the instructions. And if by mistake you did something wrong, you just have to restart the step there, okay? And you have to clear, say yes. I hope it's clear to y'all. Are you able to understand what I'm trying to say?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Great. If you have any questions, please do post in the chat itself. Go on now.
Yeah. So you can use these kind of things. And once you do, then you get your results when the experiment is typed. The student can type the results, like what did he understood. And then there will be a reflection. Like, you know, what the child understood the lab or not. There are some questions which the child has to answer. So then you'll get an idea whether the child understood the lab or not. And then there will be a summary, which is based on everything, you know, the entire practical. So like this, you can understand like what is the child facing. It is an individualized experiment for every child there. And you can ask them to send the screenshots of their completion of the lab to you, or send it to your mail, or ask them to share your screen to show the end page that they have performed. So you can understand from that whether the child is able to understand and perform the lab or not. Okay. Is this part clear to y'all? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
So you can use for various labs. I'll be using it for, this is one of the examples which I showed it right now. Okay. So this is the first thing. So you have these things like, you know, practice developing manual skills. It is not only important, like we are online right now, in the future, tomorrow you want to do the lab, but the child is not clear. You show them the video, the child will not understand. So you can ask them to do the simulation first. They'll understand, they'll clear that, okay, this is the first step, this is the second step, there are guiding steps there. So then you can actually make them do the next lab, okay? That will help the child more clearly, like what to be done, okay? For that purpose also, you can use these simulations, okay? Then practice repeating the lab to test other variables, like in hybrid teaching. Now, right now, there are some cases where the teachers are facing difficulties. Like some students are there in the class and some students are at home. because they are not in that place or because they're not able to come. So you're parallelly teaching. You're teaching to the students in the class. At the same time, you're having a FaceTime with the students who are not there. So for those kind of students, you can do these hybrid teaching there. You can give this work to the students and ask them to complete and show it to you parallelly. And they'll also have, because you can analyze your data and troubleshoot the realistic experiments. You can actually, you know, when you make the predictions that time, you can see that what mistakes the child would have made. You know, if they would have not understood the concept that DNA is negatively charged, so it will move towards the positive terminal. So definitely they would have connected the positive, instead of positive terminal, they would have connected the negative terminal. So these kind of things you can use. Okay, so then there is this called as, which is like my favorite, like called as ICAP hypothesis for labs. So I for interactive, C for constructive, A for active, and P for passive. Passive are the things like, you know, students receive the information without engaging. Like you're continuously teaching them, giving the information, but the child is, you know, he's taking the information. But there is no hands-on activities. Like active is something like where the students active their knowledge within the boundaries. Like if you're giving them some information, they're note-taking, they're making some notes, or they are saying, yes, ma'am, my thumbs are up, I can understand what you're saying. So that is kind of active. Then you see constructive. Constructing is like the simulations which we are learning, right? Create an explanatory model, generate new ideas. They can conclude, they can say the reflections, or you can ask them to explain what did you learn. So they'll explain, or they can help their friend, you know, the classmate to make them understand. So this is constructive. And the fourth one is interactive, like which we did with the lab exchange. There is so much of simulation there. You are actually doing the lab. You're removing everything. It's not like you're just changing the variables. You are taking the pipette, you're keeping the tip to it, you're taking the gel, you are loading the gel. So everything you're doing. So that is interactive there. So learning activities like passive, I'm giving an example. Students read page number 8 text. So that is a passive kind of teaching there. Active, students read page 8 text and highlight most critical sentences or critical words in that. So that is active there. The students are not only reading, they're highlighting. So some activity is done for them. Then constructive, students make some graphs or figures from whatever you learned in that page number 8. And interactive, students make pairs based on one activity sheet, complete this task collaboratively, which is based on page number 8. So this is how you can actually show your learning activities when it comes to students. Okay, this is a kind of teaching where you can actually propose them with some ideas or give them some ideas of teaching them. So I want to show some activities here. If you see, like interactive is like the lab exchange which we are using. Constructive is like your assignments, whatever you make, you ask them to write. Then you have passive, like the videos on Khan Academy and iBiology. These are all, you know, some passive activities based on the videos. You know, you ask the students to read, to watch the videos, but you don't know whether they understood the video or not. So you ask them to do some activities, you give some worksheets based on the videos, you know, ask them to watch and all this. So one more thing which I want to show here is, so I want to go back to Lab Exchange and show you something related to scrollables, okay? So this scrollable is something where the student is doing some activity, but not actually the lab. He's trying to do some reflection. Can you see this, Ruchi?
Yes, we can see it.
Yeah, so yeah. Just start this interactive, just press on this interactive lab there. So it is going, the lab is about composition of a tablet. Okay, it is loading. So you can see there are pathways, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you have to just press the arrow key to go to the next step. So you can get the reasons there, what is happening there. Okay, so this is the case, I am not well, so I need medicines, how the medicines are made. Okay, so different agents, tablets, how they provide a mechanism for safe, how these drugs are delivered in my body. So these are the facts about the drugs, you'll get it. And then you're going to learn about what is happening, how it is actually dissolving in my body, okay? And how much time it is taking. So once I go to this fifth step here, I can see there is a graph, like time after swallowing the tablet and drug blood levels. Like they'll give me an idea like, So once I go to the fifth one here, and I try to scroll down. So you can see the tablet here, then you can see the graph, and then you go back to this. You can see how many mechanisms are there, what is there. And then after that, okay, so that is how you end your work then. And then gradually after that also, there are certain questions which will you are able to solve that. So once the student solves those questions, you'll get an idea whether he understood this pathway or not. So based on that, you'll get an idea. I'm just trying to run fast. I'm not explaining the labs in detail because there is like, you know, more 20 minutes of time. We have time for the question and answer sessions also. So this is the way you can use those. You can type whatever required in that lab exchange and you can get the information from there. Can you see this slide? It's not
actually no, the it's coming all white.
Yeah, that's what, 1 second, give me a second.
Maybe it's taking time to load up.
Yeah, it's taking time to load up.
Yeah, if you have too many things open, sometimes it takes time for a slide to load the computer.
So I'm just trying to close those things.
Yeah. So let's see how people are reacting to it. What do you think? Would you like to do these kind of activities? And one of the questions that people have asked is that, are there content available for all standards?
I think it's mostly for 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th. And some basics are there for science related. It mostly focused on biology for lower grades.
Okay.
For biology, like 6th, 7th, 8th. So biology. But when you see for 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, it is focused on others like physics and chemistry also. And it is there in some 11 languages there. Like, you know, French, Spanish and all that, the labs.
But people are also asking for links of this virtual lab and from how to go from the main page of Lab Exchange, how to go to the simulation.
You just type the main page. I just showed you all right now. Just type the main page. Just type www. You can right now do it in your PC if you're there in front of the desktop. Just type labexchange.org. You'll get the main page and then you have to go to browse. Just type your name there. Just add the browse.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, do we need to subscribe? Is there any subscription?
No, it is totally free of charge. There is no cost. It is free, totally free.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah.
But you do have to subscribe in the sense you have to create your account and everything.
So if you, it's not necessary. You have to create an account if you want to use it continuously with your students for a longer period of time, then you create an account. If you want to make it as a class or pathway, assign some activities like you do in a Google Classroom. So if you want to do that, then you create a account. Otherwise, it's not required.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Ma'am, I have a query. May I ask?
Yeah, please.
Yeah. So I have tried this, like I'm working on the laptop. So once I go to Lab Exchange and I've typed titration, so it is showing me a list of text, but not the simulation. So I was trying that out. So
Right. Titration simulation. Just be very specific
Okay. Got it.
If you want a video, write titration video. So resources are there. And you go to the subjects also. Subjects is also mentioned there.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. So I was just writing titration. Maybe it is showing the text and not the actual simulation. I'll try. Thank you.
Yeah. Can you see my PPT now, Ruchi?
You share the screen?
Yeah, I'm sharing the screen.
I can see the gallery view, but not your PPT. You share the complete screen, all the desktop. And go to your PPT.
Yeah, I'm doing that, but I don't know why I'm not able to share that one. So just give me a minute.
Okay. Is your PPT on Google Slides or on?
No, it's a normal PPT.
Okay, can you mail me that?
I'm just closing it and opening it again. I'll try to do that.
Yeah. Or you can mail me and I can share. Any other questions, please, to us? Or we can, there are 20 minutes left. So if you want them to try out some things on labexchange.org in groups, we can open the breakout room and they can go in there.
Yeah, I'll do that. Give me a second. I just opened it. So I want them to... Can you see the PPT now?
Yes, we
can.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Go ahead.
So now, after this, I want you all to go to the breakout rooms. So there is a link, which I want you to add it in the
copy
chat.
Copy this and paste.
Okay. Yeah, copy it in the chat there, if possible.
You will have to copy and paste.
I'll do that.
Yeah, and also please paste the questions because people will not be able to see.
No, the questions. The questions are there in the Padlet there.
Okay, they are in the Padlet. So yeah. Just post and chat to everyone. So we will be sending you to breakout room, and we want to you to discuss these three questions. That what is the characteristic of a successful online lab? You can try out these lab exchange, explore a little bit the website itself, and you can say identify what could be the successful characteristics of it. What supports that you can identify to help you to create an online lab, and what experience or
I think
you
it's
like
there.
Share?
So this is a resource called Padlet. Okay, this is a Padlet device. So you have to just click on the link. It will take to the Padlet. And once you open that, okay, so these are the three questions. I'll just post these questions. Give me a second.
Should I open the rooms?
I have to discuss a minute to them. Just about the Padlet. So once you open the link, it will look like this. Okay. So these are some resources which Ruchi will be mailing this Padlet to you all so that you can open that and utilize this for the digital tools and for assessment and resources for online labs other than Lab Exchange and all. So there are these four questions which already were there on the PPT. So just double click on this. It will drag you here. Just write down your room number. Like room number one, if you are in room number one, and just write down what are your topics is, whatever you're thinking. Okay. We'll be there in the breakout rooms for 7 minutes. Okay, Ruchi?
Okay.
So you can. Okay.
Yeah. So I
hope everyone understood.
Yeah.
Are we going to breakout again, ma'am?
Yeah, you're going to the breakout rooms and you have to use this Padlet because the link, I'll ask Ruchi to post the link again in the breakout rooms. Mm-hmm. Or else you can copy right now and open it right now before going to the breakout rooms.
Yeah.
Okay. So once you open it, you have a Padlet on that. There is a wall where you'll be writing your views.
Okay, I'm opening the rooms, okay? So just you have to click and get inside that. I've opened the rooms. Please join. There are a few unassigned. I'm going to assign them right now. Just hold on a minute. Okay. Bhavya, do you want to move in the groups? Should I send you? And Michelle.
I think she's not accepting the breakout room session there.
Yeah.
So someone has a doubt there for the Padlet. I think we can actually, I can share my screen and see what they are typing. I think someone is typing. No one is typing there. I can see someone writing room number 4 and all that. Yeah, they are doing. I can see room number 4 is doing. So how many breakout rooms are there, Ruchi?
6 are there.
So can you send me to one breakout room so that I can guide them?
Yeah, I can do it.
Yeah. Assign me to room number 1.
Yeah. Just wait. How do I do that?
Assign, just go to the, or give me the host access, Ruchi.
Yeah, I think I'll do that.
So that I can shift from one room to other room for time being.
Okay. Yes, I have made you the host.
Okay, so I'll move to room number 1. Yes.
Okay, can you make me co-host? Because if somebody has dropped, I can't see them. I think Deepa also got dropped out. You're mute, Bhavya.
I made you the co-host.
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
Okay, now I'll go to the other breakout rooms and just let me know once 5 minutes are done, we'll ask them to get back.
You can see the timer there. In the breakout room, you can see the timer, how many minutes
are left. I can see people are writing room number. Yeah, I can see everyone is writing, Ruchi.
Okay, great.
Room number 3, room number 4, they are writing.
Yeah. Please also send me a screenshot of what they have written on the Padlet.
Okay? I'll share the screen to you, okay?
Yeah.
I'll do that. So that you can also see what they are writing. You can see room number 3. They are new to it, I think so. That's the reason. But they are doing it. So this is one
technique. Good. Quite good.
So you can ask your students also to write your views. Which part did you learn? What is it?
Yeah.
Just create a task like this, reflection, and ask your students to write about it. So they'll get an idea. Like, then you'll understand how many of y'all wrote or how many of y'all did not write actually. Mm-hmm. Are they attentive in the class or not? I can see some participant here. He's not able to join.
they when they get dropped out, no, they cannot join back. You will have to assign him.
Yeah.
Go into the breakout room and then do assign.
No. Like, he's in which breakout room? May I know?
Abhi, can you unmute and tell us?
Breakout room 1, ma'am.
Which one?
1.
Breakout room number 1.
You have to move to breakout room 1. Okay, fine. So I have assigned.
So how many minutes are left? The timer must be showing it for you.
Yeah, it is showing some 13 seconds or 30 seconds.
Okay, so people will be back automatically after that.
Yeah, it will close in 55 seconds. So should I make you the post again? Should I make you? I'll make you the post again.
You can broadcast them the message that we get ready.
I made you the host.
Okay.
Yeah, it's already, the message has gone that the breakout rooms will close.
Great. I think people are also coming back.
Yes.
Fine.
So we'll do a question and answer session. Now it is almost only 9 minutes left.
Yeah. We'll do directly question and answer, and we'll extend for 5-7 minutes. Needed if there are more questions.
And I have a feedback form. I'll share it with them. They can fill the feedback. Okay.
Sure.
Exit ticket.
Yeah. So you've shared the feedback form right now.
To you, I should share. I'll message it to you.
No, on the chat itself to everyone.
Yeah.
Yeah. So while we are having the question answer, they can also fill the feedback form.
Okay.
Yeah. One, we can see that you have tried writing on the Padlet itself. Lot of groups have written. It's really nice. Bhavya, over to you.
Yeah. Guys, I hope you all enjoyed writing on Padlet, whatever you all did. I know most of you all are doing it for the first time. So I think you'll face some difficulties, but this is the way you can actually take the reflection from the students. You can understand whether they are listening to you or not. You can make a Padlet, share it with the, make a link and share it with the students and ask them to write. What are we doing? Which topic are we learning? So you'll understand whether they are attentive in the class or not. Or if they are facing any difficulties also, they can't keep on messaging you or sending you mails. So through this Padlet reflection, you can understand which topic is difficult for them. So that next time when you have a class, you can repeat the topic with them. I hope you all enjoyed it. You all understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, so now let's start with the question and answers. So we can start with the question answers there.
Ma'am, actually, I am from breakout room 4. We could not type anything there. So,
why none of the members were not able to type? You have to just click on the question or just click anywhere on the wall and you have to start writing.
Okay. Even so if you were not able to write, why don't you share whatever you discussed here itself? In one or two lines.
So can you see my screen? Like the participants, you have to just go there. Just double click on the wall anywhere who has the link. Okay. Then like this, it will arrange. So once you click on it, once you just drag your cursor there and just type whatever you want, like XYZ, XY. So it will start typing it. So that's what you have to do. I think room 4, someone wrote there, but they were not able to type because you have to click on it twice. Got it?
Okay. Okay, ma'am.
We didn't know that.
Then the cursor will appear. So then you can start writing it. You can do it right now also if you want.
Actually, according to the question, we were not able to type, ma'am, on the particular slide. So I think we have to click that plus icon and we have to give our feedback.
Yeah, you can do that also. On the question also, you can type twice.
Okay.
Okay. So any more questions? Because we started with the question session. And guys, there is a link there in the chat, which is the Google form there, which is the exit ticket for the meeting. I just request you all to fill the form parallelly when we are having the question and answer session also. So we can understand like how was the session and what are the changes we can do, how we can modulate ourselves more, how can we make our sessions more interactive. So we'll get more ideas if you fill that. Okay, now for the question answer session, yes. What are the questions? You all can just let me know.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, may I ask a question? I'm Adit this side. I'm from New Delhi.
Okay, see.
Yeah. So, ma'am, my question is, like, once I try a Padlet, once I try that lab exchange and I find a good, simulation or practical for my class, say 11th or 12th, so I share my screen and I show it how it is working, or can I share the link to the students so that later on they can try their hands on?
No, you can share the link to the students. You can ask them the same way how you did to yourself. Actually, you can create class also. You can ask your students to make an account. So then you can create a class like in Google Classroom and add those students in your class, and you can assign the work to them. And okay. One more thing which is very good in lab exchanges, I was not getting that, you can curate the videos. Like once you go to the video, no, there are settings on that you have to click and you can show. If there is like 7 minutes video, but you don't feel the first 2 minutes and the last 1 minute is important, so you can make it from 3 minutes to 5 minutes there, and the student will be able to watch only 3 minutes to 5 minutes there.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. So it means I should, like, if I want to, like, engage and involve my students, I should make an account and then I add my students to that.
The students also should have an account.
Okay, they should also have an account, and then I can give them, like, if I show one demonstration and with some different set of concentration or other thing, mm-hmm. I tell them, okay, you try, and then next time we discuss how it was. Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, any more questions? More?
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for this wonderful session. But I have a request. Will you be conducting something more like this in future also? It would be really helpful because this is, like, I should say, first time we have got something concrete in terms of virtual labs. I have been using simulations, okay? We have been using for physics and for chemistry, but this was very concrete, like, so I would request, ma'am, if you could have more sessions on.
Yeah, actually, we and Maruchi, ma'am, are planning this on this. So we are planning to have this as a series. Like, we'll be having, this is part one. Then we'll have something else with the new virtual labs. We'll be coming up with this. Definitely, we'll think on this, right, Ruchi?
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, I'm Geetanjali from Hyderabad.
Yeah.
Ma'am, can you conduct any training sessions on many teachers, my classmates, they are not aware of this online tools.
Okay.
Can you conduct any webinars for BEd students, teachers?
Yeah, so this was one of the webinar, that we have tried. What exactly is your need if you want a webinar that would help us? If you can tell us, what exactly do you need?
Actually, I'm pursuing a BEd special education. And also, special education means it's inclusive. So we need to teach both abled and differently abled children as well. So are there any tools for both children which cater the needs of both children?
Yeah. Definitely, we'll work on this. With Ruchi ma'am and all that, we'll definitely work on this. And when this session is happening, we'll just get back to you. But there are certain tools, we'll definitely work on that. Okay, ma'am?
Yeah, but Bhavya, if you have any idea of any resources which can address special children with special needs?
So, see, it's like, it's about the need of the child, right? We call them as the God-gifted children there. The God-gifted children. So every child has a different peculiarity there. Someone is not able to view or someone is not able to understand. So the resources will be different for the child personalized need. So right now we have these labs and we have a shadow teacher where the teacher has to be next to the student in order for them to explain also. So virtually right now we are focusing on that. And even if you see, there are some people who are working on that. As soon as they are ready, I'll definitely share it with you, Ruchi.
Bhavya, you can also share your link for feedback form while we are asking, answering the question.
I shared it in the chat, right, Ruchi?
Yeah, ma'am. Can I ask a question?
Let me check. Yeah, it's there.
Yeah. Sorry. You can resend it if you want. You can reshare
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I can do that.
Yes, ma'am, say.
Yeah. Ma'am, this is, I just logged into that labexchange.com and then I could see that some of the content, actually, I went into this cellular biology. So I can see there are certain uploaded videos and whatever it is. I didn't go in. This is the first time I've been in this website. So I was thinking that it is only the uploaded can we use, or we can create our own. That is
on this site. On this site, you can definitely mail it to them. The contact is there. You can definitely send a mail to them saying that I want to add something to some videos or some information to it. Then definitely they'll respond it to you. Okay.
Right. And there is another request from our side, my side, personally, I should be saying now, that if we can have a demo of like how to take up this session in the class with the students, like can we take a topic or content from, the content which is similar to the student level, and then can we go
for that? For that, I'll just like to say this. I'll just share my screen. Give me a second. So this lab exchange, like how it has the videos, no? It has videos how to use it. Okay?
Right.
So if you go here, just I'll share my screen 1 second. Can you see my screen, Ruchi?
Not yet. Yes, we can. We can.
So you can see here search is mentioned, right? So you just go there, or you can go to browse. Just click on this, go to the library. So once you go to the library, it will take you to the library. Okay. So once you go to the library here, you can click on it and then you'll give you subject area. So you just click on that which subject you want. So you have those many videos and content per subject. You click on that. And at the same time, if you go down, you can see a scientific process or professional development. Okay, just click on that. So once you click on the professional development, it will give you some videos. I'm sorry that it's loading late. So you can see here lab exchange pathways or lab exchange guidelines, you know, tips for learning online. So these are all the resource material for teachers. You can use them. You can learn through it, and then you can do a demo with your students. And if yet you face difficulties, then we can help. Okay?
Sure, ma'am. Thank you.
Ma'am, this is I'm Geetanjali again. So, can you provide your mail ID or contact information so that we can contact you for any further help?
This is like you can always message to Ruchi and Ruchi can help me out. I'll give the feedback to Ruchi, right, Ruchi?
Yeah, sure. Yeah. So you can write to our schoolsynergy@test.edu, and we in fact would love to hear from you about any of the experiments that you have tried out with your students and your experience, or any queries. You can mail us on schoolsynergy@test.edu, and we will contact Bhavya if there are any.
I see feedbacks in the chat, but I want you all to do the feedback in the form there, right? Please do the form, because it is very useful as a facilitator. It gives us an insight, like what are the things, what the teachers want, because the form has, you know, future webinars also, what you want, like what information you want in terms. So if you fill the form, we'll get an idea like what, so we can come up with those kind of things, right, Ruchi?
Yeah.
Yeah. Any more questions or done for the day? Teachers, any more questions?
If you have any more questions, please can let us know. If not, I wanted to just ask you something. It looks like it is mostly for biology related experiment, and especially cell molecular biology and those kind of experiments. So is it also possible to do other experiments like which are in a more macro form, like or a microscope images?
You can do even 2D and 3D modeling also. There are sites, okay. But because we were running out of time, so I was not able to show. You can actually, like I just told, you can curate your video. You can show the students how much. At the same time, there are modeling sites also where you can convert your 2D structure to 3D structure. You know, the protein structure and all that. And not biology content is more, but they have the Beer-Lambert's law and all that. Suppose if I'm teaching a topic called entropy. So it gives you information related to entropy from physics point of view, from chemistry, from biology, and from engineering point of view. But you have to select your videos. So you have to select and create a pathway and send it to the students. Or when the students are entering the class, it's your responsibility to create which videos you want to watch. We can't sit in front of the students and just check which video is working, right? So we have to prepare our lessons.
Okay. So I just wanted to thank Bhavya for such an engaging and interesting session. I mean, I think each and every minute was engaging, and we got to know of a very useful resource for especially lab activities in this pandemic period when we can't take our students to the lab and they are not getting that experience, which is very, very important for learning about science itself. So once again, thank you, Bhavya. Thanks for your time. And we hope that we will be coming up with more such useful sessions in the future. Please do join every week, Saturday, 3 p.m. We will be bringing science, mathematics, English, and several other content also in these School Synergy workshops. So thank you all. Thanks a lot.
Final question. Is this the first Synergy webinar?
No, no. This is in fact the seventh. This is the seventh. And so there was one mathematics for which we have a video, which is uploaded on our channel, YouTube channel. And
what is the link of the channel?
It's the channel of CETEI. So this is, if you search for Tata Institute of Social Sciences and Center for Excellence in Teacher Education.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Find that YouTube channel. We have just mathematics video. We didn't start making videos earlier. For this also, we have not yet decided if we are going to put it up. It is based on certain permissions that we need to get going. So only after we get those permissions, we'll be able to put it up. Also, thanks a lot for.
I mean, one more future as this Synergy webinars. Do we have to join with the same ID link? Like every Saturday, as you mentioned.
Every Saturday, you will have to register for that workshop, whatever workshops you have to join. But if you have registered, we have your email ID with us. So whenever there is a new Synergy workshop, we send emails to all the registered people who had registered in the past. So just remember to, it should not go into the spam or get deleted. That's all. Otherwise, we will try to send invitation to all the people who registered in the past workshops.
No, so but for us, we registered, but this is for the first time we registered, ma'am. This is the first webinar.
Yeah, so every time you have to register, we are also, our account is also there on Facebook and Instagram. If you search for it, Center for Excellence in Teacher Education. And for every week, we post whatever the upcoming workshop is there. And we would be very happy if you share it with other participants who might be interested in this kind of workshops and would want to attend. We would want to be able to address more and more people who want to have these kind of resources. So please do share.
Sure.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Bhavya, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot.
Please do the lab and please do those Padlet activities and please share your feedback. Like, we'll be very happy to listen.
Yes, ma'am. Definitely.
Yeah.
Sure, ma'am.
Bye.
Should I end the session, Ruchi?
Yes, you can end the session, Deepa.
Okay.